but not with veterans. This despite Trump promising vets that they were a top priority all throughout the campaign.
Paul Rieckhoff is the founder of the Iraq and Afghanistan Veterans of America. He joins us now. Paul, let me give you a dramatic reading of what you put down on paper. Over the last month, lots of folks have visited Trump Tower, including rapper Kanye West, but not a single leader from our nation's leading veteran service organizations have been invited upstairs. Why did you write this? What's your concern here?
I think that speaks for itself. I mean, there's been a parade of leaders from all industries going up to Trump Tower, and not a single leader that we know of from a leading veteran service organization, not the VFW, the American Legion, IAVA. And throughout the campaign, Trump said that veterans would be a priority, and that's a good thing. We want to make sure they're a priority of his presidency as well. But the VA secretary is now really one of two remaining positions to be named, and we've heard names ranging from Sarah Palin to Rick Perry. And we've really got no direction. What kind of person is he going to pick? Is he listening to the veteran service organizations? And we think we can be a resource. We think it can help guide him in the right direction, help him understand what's really happening at VA and what veterans really need.
So, Paul, do you think that it was just lip service during the campaign? Are you really questioning if Donald Trump cares about veteran service issues?
No, I'm sure he cares, but you know, there's a lot of things on his plate right now, and he said veterans issues would be a priority. They weren't named as part of the first 100 days priorities. He hasn't met with veteran service organizations, and he's got time for rappers. So how you spend your time is a reflection of your priority.
But he has been talking to candidates here. I mean, he's had Scott Brown in. He, you know, he's a candidate. Talked to Sarah Palin. You know, you may not approve of her, but he has been meeting with people. Pete Hestis is there today.
Yeah, but there's a pretty wide spectrum here.
He has spoken about it at rallies. I understand he may not be speaking to the groups you want to, but it's not like he's ignored this issue or this post completely.
Well, he hasn't knocked down any candidates, so it's a bit disconcerting to have such a wide range. Now I think we're over a dozen candidates that have been reported in the press. We haven't seen that kind of range around really any other cabinet level position, and these are the leading veteran service organizations that represent tens of millions of members. They helped educate you all service organizations. That includes considering the current VA secretary Bob McDonald, who has support from many of the service organizations, and at least should be a consideration.
Why do you want him to stay on?
I think all the groups have seen the work he's done. It's not perfect. There's been bumps, but he's finally getting some momentum. And a big challenge at VA has been that we keep rotating leaders over and over again. This is not a small job. We're talking about 300,000 employees, almost $200 billion in the budget allocated to VA, and Bob McDonald's gotten the trust of veteran service organizations. He's also a former CEO. He came from Procter & Gamble. He's a Republican, and he's a Washington outsider. So if he wasn't at VA, he'd probably be on Donald Trump's shortlist right now.
But
we would argue that Donald Trump should also meet with Bob McDonald, talk to him, and find out what's going on under the hood at VA, because as you all have reported for the last 10 years, there are some serious issues that need tackling from the president.
Last I had heard, he hadn't been contacted. Bob McDonald said he hadn't been contacted by the transition team. I don't know if that's changed or not. Paul, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
Thanks for bringing this to us.
All right, very soon we are going to hear from President Obama himself. This is his final news conference of the year, and it comes at just a fascinating pivot point in this country. He will face questions about Russian hacking into the U.S. election system, alleged hacking, questions about Donald Trump and how he's approaching this issue. We'll bring you the news conference live.
You don't let anything keep you sidelined. That's why you drink Ensure with 9 grams of protein and 26 vitamins and minerals. For the strength and energy to get back to doing what you love. Ensure. Always be you.
Well, finished.
You wouldn't want your painter to quit partway.
Think you missed a spot.
So when it comes to pain relievers, why put up with just part of a day?
Aleve. Live whole, not part.
You want this color over the whole house.
I didn't realize how bad my smile was with fillings and root canals. I had to do something. I looked at partial bridges. I looked at dentures.